Greetings, people all over the world. Paul Muckley here again. Today is August 22nd, 2011 at 10:56 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Christians, what I'm going to say to you right now, right? I say it with a heavy heart. I have no pleasure in saying it because, like you, I grew up believing that Jesus Christ was my Lord and Savior, that He was born on Christmas Day, that He grew up, He died for my sins, and He rose on the third day, and to Him I'm going to receive salvation. And Paul in the Bible said, if you do not believe that Jesus Christ rose from the dead, then your faith is in vain. If you do not believe that, in order for you to have salvation, in order for you to go to heaven, you must believe that Jesus Christ was born, that He was crucified, and He rose on the third day. You have to believe that. If you don't believe that, then your faith is in vain. Christians, like you, my faith in Jesus Christ was in vain. It was in vain because I could prove to you that Jesus Christ was never born. He never ever walked the face of the earth. Never. Because the Bible is a futuristic thing. Okay? It's not for the past, it's for the present and future. The Bible is a living thing. So, if you read the Revelation, it tells you that Christ was crucified in Egypt. Read it. I can't remember which part in the Revelation, but he said where also our Lord was crucified in Egypt. And it's an allegory. What's Egypt? Egypt is America. Because America is a country that carries all Egyptian symbols and are using them. And the dollar, in God we trust. The pyramid and the eye. The House of Representatives, the Congress and all that. The secret treasures they have there. America is in New Egypt. They have the secret treasures from Egypt. In that dome. The Capitol building, I think it is. Okay? That's where they said we entrust these secrets to guard them. Something like that. Anyway. America is in New Egypt. We also a lot of crucified. When I say crucified, I don't mean kill him on a cross. It means you put him in prison. You freak up his life. You try to punish him. You do all kind of manner of evil against him. That's why it's called crucifying somebody. In Egypt, we also a lot was crucified. So, Christ was not crucified in Israel because he didn't come yet. He was not born yet. Okay? He was not born in those times. Now is the time Christ is here. But Jesus Christ was an imposter. The light channel will prove it to you. Now people, first let's turn to the genealogy of Jesus Christ, okay? Matthew chapter 1, let's start at verse 6. I'm going to use your Bible, people. I'm going to use the Bible to prove to you that Christ was never born. And if anyone just still believe that Jesus Christ was born, after I use your own Bible and show you it's an impossibility, then you're that damn idiot. And you deserve, if a devil come and get you, you deserve it. Because you created the devil, just you created your Jesus Christ. I'll prove to you he was never born. Using your own Bible. Not my words. Your Bible. That your Jesus Christ was never born. So therefore, your faith was and is in vain. You are your own Messiah. When you were born, that's when your Messiah was born. Because which man can save his brother's soul? Wisdom is better than silver and gold. And I want to give you some wisdom right now. Matthew chapter 1 verse 6. Okay, remember, Jesus Christ came from the seed of David, the lineage of David. Okay, remember, David was the father of Solomon. Solomon was the father of Rehoboam with an R. Rehoboam was the father of Abijah. Okay, according to the Bible, Jeroboam was the father of Abijah, and Abijah was the father of Asa, and from that lineage came you, Jesus Christ. Okay, so remember, Jesus Christ had to have come from the lineage of David for him to be the Messiah, because that was the promise. But I'm going to show you that Jesus Christ was never born. because Abijah, people look at it, right? Read verse 7. Matthew 1 verse 7. Solomon begat Rehoboam. Rehoboam begat Abijah, A-B-I-J-A-H. And Abijah begat Asa. Remember, Abijah is A-B-I-J-A-H. And Rehoboam is R-E-H. Hold up, where am I at? Rehoboam is R-E-H-O-B-O-A-M. Okay. But I will prove to you people that Abijah could not have begat Asa because Abijah died when he was a child. People, Abijah died as a child. So therefore, Abijah died as a child, that means the lineage of Christ was cut. He was severe. So if the lineage, okay. People, if my father died before my father was when he was a child. If my father died when he was a child, how could I be here? Huh? It's an impossibility unless you use some kind of DNA. Okay? If my father died before his son was born, I wouldn't be here today. So if Abijah died, would you agree with me, people? If I could prove to you that Abijah died when he was a child, would you agree to me that Christ could not have been born? Okay, let's go. 1 Kings chapter 14. 1 Kings chapter 14. Now, people, remember, right? There were two kings. Jeroboam, who was the king. Because people remember, right? Remember, Solomon had so many wives. He sinned, right? And God told him that when he died, he's going to take the kingdom from him and rip it in two. And he'll give 10 tribes to Israel and 2 tribes to Solomon's son Jeroboam. Rehoboam, Rehoboam is Solomon's son. So God promised he'll give Solomon's son 2 kingdoms and he'll give 10 to Israel. The king of Israel was a commoner. He wasn't a king, with a commoner. His name was Jeroboam with a J. We have Rehoboam and we have Jeroboam. Rehoboam is the son of Solomon. Jeroboam is a commoner, the king of Israel. Okay? Now, people, Abijah was not the son of Rehoboam. Abijah was the son of Jeroboam. Abijah was the son of a commoner, and he died when he was a child. Abijam was the son of Solomon's son. But he's not the lineage of Jesus Christ. So I'll prove it to you. So anyway, I'm gonna cut it short because YouTube won't give me, YouTube cut my time now. Before I had like 2 hours or more. Now they cut my time to 15 minutes. So I don't know why they did that. So maybe the channel censor me as much as they can. I don't know. Maybe they did it to all of YouTube. But I only have 15 minutes, so I'm gonna cut it short. In 1 Kings chapter 14 verse 1. He tell you people that Abijah, the son of Jeroboam, fell sick. People, verse 1, at that time, Abijah, the son of Jeroboam, fell sick. But Matthew tell you that Abijah was the son of Rehoboam. So what Rehoboam did, so what Jeroboam did now, he sent his wife to Abijah, the prophet. Ahijah, the prophet, to beg him to heal his son because his son was sick. So when she went there to see the prophet disguised now, you read it for yourself, okay, I'm just going to give you the rundown. So when she went to see the prophet now to ask him to heal her son, the prophet told her, no, your child is going to die because his son was a wicked man. He didn't listen to God. God gave him the kingdom and he had the people worshiping idol. He made costly people to worship, so God kill his son so that his seed will cut off forever. Read it, people. So in verse, he tell you, right? Wow, I'm gonna run out of time. Anyway, from verse 11 to 14, I think it tells you that the child Abijah died, and God destroyed Jeroboam and his seed. Okay, now 1 Kings chapter 14, verses 27. Now we get to Rehoboam, who is really the son of Solomon. Okay, let's go to verse 25. 1 Kings 40, verse 25. And it came to pass in that fifth year of King Rehoboam that Shishka, king of Egypt, came up against Israel, and he took away the treasures of the house of the Lord and the treasures of the king's house. He took away all the whatever. Anyway, and King Rehoboam was the son of Solomon, right? And verse 30 tell you, and there was war between Rehoboam and Jeroboam, okay, all their days. And Rehoboam slept with his father and was buried with his father in the city of David, and his mother name was Naham, an Ammonite. And Abijam, see people, Abijam his son reigned in his stead. So people, the son of Abijah, look, really people, the son of Rehoboam was Abijam. But if you go to Matthew chapter 1, in verse 7, it tells you the son of Rehoboam was Abijah. Every single Bible you find, people, every single Bible you find, it have the same mix up. Was it a mistake? People, this Bible was written for over 2,000 years ago. It has been written for millions, it has been written trillions of times. Are you going to tell me that no one caught this mistake? It was not a mistake, it was not a typo, it's reality. They got confused, they're trying to fake it, and they got caught up. Paul Muckle got caught them, this little man. This man, this uneducated man, caught up their lies. Read the genealogy of Jesus Christ in Matthew chapter 1. And then read 1 Kings chapter 14, verse 1 to 31. And you will see that Jesus Christ could not have been born because Abijah was not the son of Rehoboam. And Abijah died when he was a child. And the son of Rehoboam, who is the son of Solomon, was Abijam, A-B-I-J-A-M. Now people, go to Matthew chapter 1 and tell me where you see Abijam, A-B-I-J-A-M. It's not there. It's Abijah. But Abijah died when he was a child, as is told from 1 Kings chapter 14, 1 to 14. 1 to 16, he tell you he died as a child. And we know Jeroboam was not the son of Solomon. Jeroboam was the king of Israel. We know Rehoboam was the son of Solomon. So you see the lies, people, you see how they're getting caught up. So people, now if Abijah died when he was a child, how could Christ have been born? How could Jesus Christ came from the lineage? So you see they get caught up, people. This Bible has been written so many times. Do you tell me that was a typo? No. Because Jesus Christ was never born yet. He was just not born. His name is Paul Merkel. Because in your Bible it tells you, you shall leave your name as a curse for my chosen. But the Lord shall slay you and shall call his chosen by a different name. The name is Paul Merkel. One day you are going to realize. But don't make me have to do what I know I'm going to have to do to force you all to realize. Woe is me for my hurt. And you are making me do stuff just to prove to you all who I am. That's like that bringing fire from heaven. That's what you all want me to do, bring fire from heaven to prove you all who I am. Know my people, that's destructive. Look at all my videos. How much more must I show you all? I just proved to you Christ could not have been born, so your faith was in vain. You have to believe that Christ was born and crucified and raised from the dead, or your faith is in vain. He was neither born He that did was he crucified, now was he raised.